was John Jackson.
John, come on in and I'll help you choose your tree.
Thank you.
Well, today we're giving away seedlings that are produced from seeds that we collected from healthy trees in eastern Ontario. These trees might have the genetic tolerance that we see in the parent trees. We hand out 2,000 every year and encourage the landowners to protect them for at least 10 years to get them growing. And this is to replace the dead and dying trees, butternut trees, from the canker disease out there. Information about the disease suggests that it is introduced on plant material, probably Japanese walnut material, in the 1850s. And then that plant material was disseminated out throughout North America to nut enthusiasts. The native butternut here in North America don't have a genetic memory of this disease, so they have no or very little tolerance to it. I go out in the summer and the fall to myriad properties in eastern Ontario, searching for trees that are showing signs of tolerance. And I also work for the Forest Gene Conservation Association. They do all of the archiving, so the grafting of this genetic material. So it's all tied together in terms of finding the trees, cloning them, collecting seed from them. Again, our sort of mandate is to help butternut persist on the landscape. Overall, the survival rate is about 30%. Which is 30% more than what was there. Butternut is a solid member of the biodiversity of Ontario. We should never allow a species to be taken out of that context because of something that we've done. And this is clearly something we've done.